Hi, today we are going to learn about tablet manufacturing and its defects. What are the manufacturing defects of the tablets? So in the tablet manufacturing, I am not going to deal in detail. I will just give you a physical overview or idea how the tablet is getting manufactured. Okay, in any process, either it we take a tablet or a capsule, dispensing of the raw material is the first process. So we need to dispense the raw material. Okay, we'll collect the raw material as per the formula. Then we weigh the raw material, then we sieve the raw material to get the required size or to avoid any lumps present in the raw material. Then we dry blend them. Okay, we blend the raw material according to the formula, we mix them. After mixing, depending upon the type of tablet or type of tablet compression, we need to carry out three processes, that is direct compression or granulation. Again, in the granulation, we have wet granulation and dry granulation. If it is a depending on the regarding the granulation process, I already explained in my video. I will give that link in description or in the icon. Go and check it out. Okay. In dry blend, after the dry blending, if the excipients are directly compressible and your drug is directly compressible, then we go for direct compression process. After blending, we'll compress the tablet directly by adding direct compressible binders. Then we go for granulation. Okay, if the powder is not directly compressible, then the other way of getting the tablet done, tablet process to be done, is wet granulation or dry granulation. If your drug is susceptible to heat, thermoliable, or if your drug is hydrolyzed by the water, hydrolyzable, then we need to go for dry granulation. After dry granulation, we get the granules, take the granules, mix the granules with the fines, then with the excipients or dry binders, then we mix again, we mix them, then we punch to get the tablet. In wet granulation, after getting the granules by the wet granulation process, we add them to the fines, then we add lubricant gliadin. Here also we add lubricant gliadin, then we mix them, then we punch them to get a tablet. So this is the overview for the tablet manufacturing process. Then we go for the defects of the tablets. In the manufacturing of the tablets, what are the defects we are going to see while you are manufacturing the tablet? So in the manufacturing defects, depending on the variables, we have three types of defects we are going to encounter. What is that? Process related. What is the process you are following? Let's say you are drying the granules. So while drying, if you over dry the granules, what happens? What kind of defect can occur due to over drying of the granules? Then we have formulation related. In the formula, if you add more fines, or if you add less fines, or if your binder is more or less concentration, or if your something is present in the formulation which is not compressible, then we need to know what happened. So what are the problems occurs when we do some mistake in the formulation part. What I mean to say is, let's say capping. For the capping, the problem of capping can occur from the process related variables, or from the formulation related variables, or from the machine related variables. From there you can get a capping. Like and every defect, we have three problems from which the defect can be origin, that is process related, formulation related, and machine related. Now let's see one by one what are the causes. Okay, what is capping? Capping means division of the tablet into two distinctive layers. Okay, so the upper part or lower part will come as a cap, so we call it as a capping. Now what are the reasons related to the processes? Okay, if you over dry the granule while drying, if you are preparing the tablet by wet granulation method, if you over dry the granule, then what happens? The process related variables will occur. If you over dry the granules, then what happens? Obviously, capping will occur. What happens if the granules are over dried? They will not bind to each other. They will not form a monolithic system. They just segregate. While segregating, they segregate in layer, hence we call it as a capping. So this is the process related problem through which capping can occur. How can we avoid that? Dry the granules properly. Then formulation related, if binder is not in good quantity, less quantity of binder has been added, then if fines are not added properly, inadequate fines, so due to that reason capping occurs. So why? We'll see what are the reasons for that. If the binder is not there, obviously you know the particles will not bind together properly, and it may lead to the capping problem. Next, same in the formulation related, if the fines are not in proper position, like 15% fine we are going to add, if that fines are not there in the proper ratio, then you will encounter capping. How? Let's assume this 4 are a granule. Okay, if you keep that granule close, see, we'll see some air entrapped here. The space present, interparticular space present between these 4 granules, there is some part of air is been entrapped. Now when you compress, when you punch without adding fines, when you punch this as a tablet, then what happens? That air which is there inside that interparticular space will get compressed. Along with the granules, air will also will get compressed. But what is the property of air? After some time, while you are compressing, it will get compressed, but it will try to decompress itself. Okay, you compress like this, then we get the tablet. After 1 hour or 2 hours, slowly tablet start to form capping. Why? The compressed air will start to relax. When it start to relax, then what happens? Obviously, we get a capping problem. So how to avoid that? If you add fines, that fines will go and sit in this interparticular space. Like this, avoiding amount of air being compressed. Okay, that air present in the interparticular space will be replaced by your fines. Due to that, if you compress the tablet by adding the fines, because there is less air, so we won't see the capping problem. Now, machine related, if your machine is wear and tear, if your machine is not been handled properly, or you can say the dies and the cavities are not been polished regularly, then what happens? This may lead to the capping. Okay, whatever the upper part is there, when the die comes and compress, sorry, when the punch come and compress the powder into the tablet, the powder which is present at the upper part may go along with the punch. We can see this problem in sticking, as well as here that upper layer is being separated from the tablet, which is called as a capping. So you need to maintain the machine in a good condition and in a well polished condition. So this how you can avoid capping with these 3 techniques. Next we have lamination. What is lamination? The tablet will segregate into distinct 2 layers, more than 2 or 3 layers. In capping, only tablet is separating into 2 layers. Here we have more than 2 layers, then we call it as a lamination. Same why it occurs, same reasons as that of your process related, formulation related and machine related. We'll see what are those. Process related, if the granules are not been dried properly, then we get a lamination problem related to process. Okay, then we have formulation related. Same, if you don't add good fines, quality of fines, and if you don't add sufficient lubricant or sufficient binder, then we encounter lamination. Then machine related, air entrapment is both same for capping, same process is there for capping and the lamination. Okay, machine related, if the turret speed is more while punching, so what happens, upper and lower punch, they will come at the punching station, they will punch and they will go like this. Okay, again they will come at the punch, they will punch and they will go. What in this process, if the speed is more like this, okay, if the speed is more, what happens? There is no, you are not giving sufficient time for the punch to compress the tablet. Okay, if the speed is more, there is no sufficient time for the punch to compress the tablet, and the tablet after getting punched will get segregated into layers because the punching force is not been exerted properly or passed properly from the punch to the powder to form a tablet. The tablet will not hold its integrity, and hence it will separate it into layers. This what is related to machine. So maintain the speed of the machine so that you can avoid lamination. The reason for lamination is, if you are going to punch the tablet, let's say if your die cavity is like this, if you are going to punch the tablet. After punch, you will get a tablet in this shape from this die cavity. Now after punching, the material will tend to relax, expand. Okay, while expand, if you keep the die cavity in this shape, while expanding, this tablet will expand in unevenly. It will won't expand evenly, it expand unevenly. Due to this, the tablet may segregate into layers. Hence, to avoid that, we need to taper the dies, tapered dies we say. Okay, just incline 3 to 5 degrees incline dies we take. When you punch the tablet, initially you get the tablet in this shape. Slowly when it relax, again it will come back to the original shape. Okay, to avoid lamination, you need to use the taper dies. Remember this. Why? You need to give the space for the tablet for expansion. The tablet will try to expand. Okay, what do you mean by cracking? You can see the cracks on the tablet, either at the upper surface or lower surface. Very rarely you see cracks on the sides, but majorly we are going to notice the cracks on upper or lower surface of the tablet. What is the reason for this? We will see. Related to process, if you dry the granule over, over dried granules causes your cracking problem. Okay, then what are the reasons related to formulation for the cracking? If the fines are not used in proper, okay, if the binder is not proper, again it will dry, it leads to cracking. And next is machine related. What is the problem? If the dies or if your punches are too concave like this, if the punch is like this, now what happens? While giving the force, obviously force will be more exerted here, and at the center we have only less force to be exerted. Due to this, what happens after the tablet comes out? Tablet will be in this shape. Okay, there will be uneven expansion of the tablet surface, upper and bottom surface. Okay, due to this uneven expansion, you can see cracks here like this at the surface, upper or lower surface. Due to why this is happening? Related to machine, due to using more concave shaped dies, it will cause your cracking problem due to uneven expansion. Obviously, cracks you observe due to uneven expansion of the tablet. What do you mean? Next process is chipping. What do you mean by chipping? Chipping is broken edges of the tablets. Okay, the tablet edges will come out as a chips. What is the reason for this? Obviously, process related to dry granules, and formulation related, if you add more binders at the lower part, it will cause a chipping. Okay, binder is more, it will adhere to the punches, so it will be chipped there. In related, what are the problems caused for, so how chipping caused due to machine related problems? If the machine is not polished clearly, okay, then what happens? The surface of the tablet will get stick to the punch and it will be picked up. Due to that, chipping occurs. Chips, the tablet will be torn off like a chip at the edges. This problem we call it as a chipping. This how you can avoid chipping. Okay, use proper dried granules or use proper binders or die binders. Then use dies or punches which are been polished. Sticking. What do you mean by sticking? Remember this, sticking and picking are the same terms, but only thing difference here is that tablet will get stick to the die cavity. Okay, so in the tablet manufacturing process, we have like here we have punches, we have die here, inside we have die cavity, then we have punch. This is the lower punch, this is the upper punch, and this is the die. Inside the die cavity, after the punching process takes place, the tablet has to eject, but it will get stick to the walls of the die cavity. Why it is getting stick, we'll see. Process related, if the granules are not dried properly, less drying time, because the granules are very wet, they will go and stick to the walls of the die cavity. Formulation related, too much binder, okay, or you can say less binder or too much binder addition will leads to the sticking problem. Or lubrication is not proper. Proper lubrication is not there. Mainly, proper lubrication is not there for the tablet to come out. So it will get stick to the die cavity. Remember, sticking means sticking of the tablet to the die cavity. Picking is picking of the tablet surface, some part of the tablet to the from punches. Punches will go after punching. The punch will pick the some part of the powder from the tablet. That we call it as a picking. Okay, picking also occurs due to process related. If that granules are not dried, they are wet in condition, then they will go and adhere to the punches. Remember, adherence to the punches is picking, adherence to the dye cavity is sticking. Then formulation related, say good lubricant, lubricant quantity is insufficient in your formula of the tablet, it will pick by the punches. Next, machine related, both sticking and picking. Machine related problem is not using polished dies or punches, because that edges are not soft, they will go and they will stick to those edges, because the if a edges is soft or edges is plain, then the tablet will eject easily. If the edges of the die cavity is not proper, or if you are using punches, the punch surface is not polished, it has some impressions there, these impressions will pick the powder from the tablet surface. So due to this sticking and picking error, machine related problem for sticking and picking. Sticking is adherence of the tablet will come out, but some part of the tablet will get stick to the dye wall. We call it as sticking. But binding is tablet will not come out from the dye wall, it will stay there itself. That is called binding. Why this happens? If you use small, okay, we'll see for the process related variables. If the granules are not dried properly, they are wet in condition, they have more cohesive nature, they will get bind to the dry cavity and they will not come out. Next, formulation related, if you are using more binders, okay, there is a chance that when the drying is not proper, the binder may get bind to the tablet. Okay, tablet will be staying there. Next, machine related, if you are using a die cavity which is very small compared to the dose of, or compared to the amount of the powder going into that. Die cavity is small, amount of powder going into that is more, then when you punch, whole tablet will stick there. We want only some amount of powder to be going there. If that powder goes excess, then there will be a problem. So how to avoid this binding? Use the dies of proper size related to machine. Okay, next is mottling. What do you mean by mottling? Mottling is uneven distribution of color on the surface of the tablet or within the tablet. So why this happens? If you use a we'll see the process related. If you don't dry the granule properly, we get mottling. Why? I will tell you in the next process. Okay, formulation related, if you use a excipient which is having other colors than the other excipient, let's say I am using all the excipients, we have A, B, C, D excipient, in that A is in red color, remaining are in white color, obviously you will get mottling problem. Okay, related to machine, mottling we don't have any problems related to machine. Okay, so what happens in the drying process and the formulation, we'll see. If you add a colorant in wet granulation, I'm saying, okay, you prepare a granule, let's say this is a granule, you added colorant, now colorant is distributed evenly in a granule. I'm taking one granule and try to explain what happens in the mottling. So the color is distributed properly. If you, when the solvent is getting evaporated, the solvent the colorant is also soluble in the solvent. Along with the solvent, colorant will also move to the upper surface, because evaporation is in this direction. Now what happens at the final stages, all the volatile solvent will get evaporated, but the color will get accumulated at the surface of the granule. Initially it has been distributed evenly, but due to the color is soluble in the solvent, and when you are drying, the solvent is evaporating, the color will also travel along with the solvent, but solvent can't leave the granule, hence the solvent will leave the granules and the colorant can't leave the granule, hence the granule the colorant will stay at the upper position of the granule. Now if you punch this type of granules, what happens? Obviously you will find uneven distribution of color on the tablets. Okay, so here drying process and formulation will play key role in the mottling. So avoid that colorant as much as possible, or use a solvent in which solvent is not soluble. Next we have double impression. What do you mean double impression? Now let's say you have to impression on the tablet. Let's say my impression is like this. So N, this impression I have to impress on the tablet. Okay, so this is the tablet. I want this impression to present on the tablet. Now what happens? If you see that punching machine, we have two stations where one is filling station, another is punching station, or you can say ejection station. Okay, at one station it will get filled, other station it will get punched, and other station it will get ejected. So we have punching station and ejection station where the punches will come and meet together. Okay, now what happens while punching? The tablet will get compressed and the envelope, that logo is being transferred to the tablet. Assume that logo is on the lower punch. Okay, while punching, the logo is being transferred. You can keep logo anywhere, upper punch or lower punch. Okay, I am just taking an example of the lower punch and explaining. At punching station, they will get punched. The punches will come close, they will punch the powder into tablet and they will impose the logo on the tablet. Now when they go to ejection station, in this time the lower punch only will get activated. Due to this, what happens, this lower punch will eject the tablet slightly by rotating. Okay, when the during the traveling time between the punching and ejection, there is a chance that the lower punch will get uncontrolled rotation. Initially it was like this, so I will get impression like this. If it slightly turns, what happens, you will get impression again like this, because the lower punch is slightly turned, so you will get another impression. This we call it as a double impression. What is the reason for this? There is no process or formulation related reason for this. The pure reason for the double impression is mechanical or machine related, because you are uncontrolled movement of punches. How to avoid this? We try to incorporate anti-turning device into the machine. So newer machine which are coming now have anti-turning device in them. In this way, after the punching, during the time between punching and the ejection station, that punches will not rotate. There will be no free rotation of the punches. This will avoid your double impression. I hope you understand. Thank you.